MLB The Show's coverage of Major League Baseball brings us to the great state of Florida and Marlins Park in Miami. Tonight, the second of four between the Cincinnati Reds and the Miami Marlins. Miami attempt to end a six-game losing streak. Next. Andy Barnhart, a righty from the state of Ohio, will do the pitching in this one. What do we need to know here, Danny?
Man, he pitched really well in his last one without allowing a single run and picking up the victory. Let's see if he can bring that stuff back to the ballpark with him and make it two really strong starts.
Here's Billy Hamilton standing in, and we are set for baseball here this evening.
Billy Hamilton.
Here comes the first pitch. Second of four here on a Friday night as the game's first pitch is taken for strike one. Guys, this Marlins ball club, as they begin play here tonight, they are in the midst of a pretty bad stretch as they've dropped six straight coming in.
Yeah, I get it, Matty. The team's on a moderate losing streak right now. Can't be happy with the way they've played, but they have to find a way to relax a little bit. Everybody goes through these little stretches, these little valleys throughout the course of a long season. This team should right itself, and it needs to start today.
The 1-1. This one's chopped foul right at the plate. The count moves now to 1-2. High and deep to right. Piscotty going back to the track, to the wall. Gone to lead off the inning. So it's a solo home run here leading off the ball game. Eighth home run on the season for him. As the Reds strike first, it's 1-0.
Talk about hitting the ground running. Usually a leadoff man is the guy that takes the first pitch, trying to get the feel for the pitcher, trying to get dialed in, but not this guy. He's got that C ball hit ball philosophy, and he does just that, launching that pitch out of here before the fans could even get settled in the seats.
Ready now for Cincinnati, Cesar Hernandez. First shot for him here, and with the season winding down, he's closing in on a league batting title. First offering on its way. Sent on the ground out to second. Oh, what a play! How about that?
Batting first baseman number 19, Joey.
In now for the Reds, Joey Votto. He's carrying a batting average of just over 300, so clearly he's been a productive player with the bat in his hand so far. First pitch of the at bat on its way. Hard hit toward the hole. A dive, but he can't knock it down. It's through for a base hit.
Hey, just a nice piece of hitting right there. He's able to keep his hands inside that ball, stay square as long as possible, and feed it into the opposite field for a base hit.
And that brings up Scott Schebler. He swings and grounds it to short. Bare-handed for one. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. But the Reds hit the scoreboard first on this solo homer. Bottom of the first coming up, and the Reds are staked to an early 1-0 lead. Robert Stevenson, the California-born right-hander, is on the mound. What's your take on him, Dan?
One of the things that jumps out if you look at that stat sheet, a very high whip coming into this start. One of the things he's going to have to do a much better job, keep traffic off the bases, keep the walks down, try to limit the amount of hits. He's had a rough go of that so far this year. Let's see if he can turn it around in this one.
So coming to the plate, Gene Segura. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. High in the air out to center field. Hamilton is under it. One down. We have a moment here in Miami to take a look at the Marlins' starting lineup. D-Ro, what's your take as they look to end their losing streak?
Yeah, Matty, a lot of professional at-bats up and down this lineup. I know they're behind right now, but it only takes one guy to set the tone and get the boys going.
Digging in, the switch hitter, Jed Lowry, as the switch hitter will take his cuts left-handed here.
One of the things this guy would like to do from the left side is swing it a little bit better against right-handed pitching. This guy has decent numbers, but not great numbers against right-handed pitchers.
And guys, as we take a look at the Reds entering play here tonight, 4-2 over their last six games, including a win last time out.
Yeah, Matty, this team has been playing really well right now, and this is case in point. Chance to jump out again to another 1-0 lead. They've really been doing that. They've been on attack, early offensive, almost ambush-like approaches to their at-bats, and it's working for them.
Batting third,
stepping in, JT Realmuto, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. First pitch on its way. And a fastball in the dirt that's taken for a ball. Lays off the fastball away, and it's 2-0. Count, here it comes. Down low, and the plot thickens here, 3-0. The 3-0 fastballs in for a strike.
This is where, if you're the batter, one pitch, one spot, and you get the barrel of the bat to that baseball as quick as possible with damage on your mind.
Two out, nobody on. And a good job there to lay off. It's ball four as he becomes their first base runner of the ball game now with two away.
Boy, oh boy, that's a tough one for the pitcher. He's definitely wondering, where the heck was that pitch? I think he called it high, but our strike zone says otherwise.
Next will be the cleanup hitter, Stephen Piscotty, to check out how he did in August versus how he's finishing off the season down the stretch here in September. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. And he takes ball one.
This is where you got to take stock in the situation. Adjust your batting gloves and realize you need a gapper to score this guy from first. If nothing less, pass the baton to the guy behind you and keep the line moving.
Here we go. A ball and a strike now. Now a throw over, and he'll get dirty, but he's back in safely. The 1-1. Fouled off again, and now he's in a 1-2 hole. The 1-2 is taken for ball two. Started to go. Did he hold up in time? Yes, says the first base umpire. It's ball three now. Throw over to the bag, just keeping him close. Realmuto is off at first with two away. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Hamilton is under it. And that retires the side. One left for Miami. They trail this one 1-0. Stepping up now, Scooter Gennett. And the home away splits tell us he's actually quite a bit better hitting on the road than he is at home. First pitch of the at bat on its way. A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one. 1-0. And set up behind the plate is Kenny Jansen, as you see the rest of the umpiring crew there.
Hey, the book on Kenny Jansen, D-Ro, not a very big zone, but he will give you that low pitch below the knees.
Yeah, and he's consistent. You're okay with that as an offensive player. He wants to give that pitch below the knees. If this pitcher can execute consistently, you better make the adjustment.
One ball, one strike, the count. The 1-1. Misses, ball two.
I don't blame him for not coming over the heart of the plate. He circled this guy on the lineup card when he got to the yard today. He's been swinging one of the hotter bats in the game.
All right, Marlin. Now the 2-1. Pitch is popped up. Lowry over to his left. One out.
All right, here's the defensive alignment for the Miami Marlins. And if you look at the numbers on this team, defensively, they're in the top five fewest errors in the league. Flashing the leather, picking and grinning. Keep an eye on them. They play stout defense.
So digging in now, Tucker Barnhart. He'll swing it from the left side right here. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Missed with a breaking ball.
Counts 1-0.
One out, nobody on. Now it's 2-0.
Well, here's a guy we know is swinging it pretty well at the plate lately, and based on those last two pitches, I think I know why. He's doing a great job of putting himself at counts where he's likely to be successful.
And a good comeback fastball there. It's two balls and a strike. And he misses low here, so the count goes to 3-1. The 3-1 finds the zone to fill the count, 3-2. Now the 3-2 pitch. He loses him on ball four.
Man, that's just painful for a pitcher right there. A 3-2 offering that was right on the corner, but he couldn't get him to chase, and he doesn't get the call. Can't beat yourself up about that one too much.
In now, Cliff Pennington, as he will take a fastball in there at the knees for strike one. And he lays off for ball one. The 1-1. Is looked at for ball number two. Now the 2-1 pitch. Now a swing here on the fastball as this is squirted up the first baseline. And that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit. And they'll have runners at second and third following the one out double.
The good news for pitchers in this park is that it doesn't give up many home runs. A lot of room in the outfield. Sometimes that's the bad news as well, though, because there's a lot of space for hits to get down and to go for extra bases just like that.
That'll bring in Philip Ervin. And as you check out his righty-lefty splits, no surprise that he hits better against southpaws than he does against right-handers. He's set, and the pitch. And a neck-high fastball that time.
Amazing he was able to lay off in this situation. Your eyes light up when you get something above the belt, especially with a man on third base.
Come on, let's hold him.
Now the 1-0. He is taken high above the zone.
With the infield back and a runner at third, he's definitely pitching for a strikeout or maybe something like a harmless pop-up. You could see it from that high fastball, but that was just a good job of laying off that pitch.
Hey. 2-1.
That's a nasty pitch right there. You got to tip your hat as the hitter. You get a nasty slider like that, there's nothing you can do. Actually, a quality take.
The 2-1 is in there for the second strike.
Hey, I don't care what league you're in, American, National, if you're playing on Mars, if you get a heater down the middle of the plate as an eight-hole hitter, you better be swinging the bat.
Working for the punch out and the offering. And he misses this one inside, and that'll run things full, 3-2.
That turns out to be a good take on that front door breaking ball, but you have to wonder if that pitch buckled him at all. That was really close to clipping the inside corner.
It's getting out here.
He's set. Here's the 3-2. Holds off on the slider, and that's a good idea as it's ball four.
Wow, if that's not a strike, I don't know what is. I know these subs have a tough job. I get it. We'll see if he gets the next borderline call or if there are any makeup calls coming up.
So here's the Reds pitcher, Robert Stevenson. And you see that average below the dreaded Mendoza line. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Takes a high fastball for a strike.
Getting that first pitch strike is really important when you're dealing with the bases loaded behind you. Good job to give himself the advantage there.
Outside for a ball, 1-1. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Fastball stays way up that time for ball two.
You put yourself in a situation, you got to get yourself out of it. You got the pitcher at the plate, 2-0 count. You got to take your chances and throw something middle of the plate.
Now the 2-1. The count now at 2-2. The 2-2 one more time. Hit down the line at third. Scooped up. They get the force at the plate. Relay to first in time. And just like that, the side is retired. A couple of walks, but no damage. We're back to Friday Night Baseball on the show after this. Now at the plate, Derek Dietrich, as they'll have 5, 6, and 7 here to start the home half of the second.
Derek Dietrich.
First pitch coming, here it is. There's a fastball that just misses, ball one. Now the 1-1 pitch. That's softly hit to right. Will that get down? Nope. A nice job by the retreating first baseman to look it in for the out.
Time for a look at the Cincinnati Reds on deck. Hey guys, let's focus our attention on center fielder Billy Hamilton, a pitcher's dream out there covering gap to gap. He makes the extraordinary play look routine. Seriously, probably the best range of any center fielder in the game.
at the plate, Brian Anderson. He went hitless last night in a game where his guys could push across only one score. First delivery to him on the way. Fastball off the plate away. It's ball one. And that's off the plate and high. 2-0 now.
Back-to-back pitches, they've gone away. Do you tell yourself as a hitter he wants to come in right here? I don't think so. I think he's trying to find that outside corner and adjust accordingly.
Called strike on the change, 2-1.
Love the pitch call there, 2-0. You know the guy's geared up for a fastball, and you drop a changeup in the zone, that's going to be a tough pitch to handle.
Now the 2-1. Count even at 2-2.
You pull a fastball like that, you got to tell yourself to slow it down a little bit, play more gap to gap, and keep that front shoulder square, pointed towards the pitcher. That'll keep everything on plane.
And a fastball flew it right by him, and they're two down.
Man, I love watching a pitcher that just rears back and blows smoke by a guy at the letters. That's the ultimate challenge pitch, and for me personally, watching hitters swing and miss, man, that's a sight of beauty.
Into the box now, Leo Estrada, as he lays off a fastball too low for ball one. Let's check in with an average still south of 230. Four home runs and 19 driven in. And they won't get him to chase the curveball in the dirt that time, and it's 2-0 now.
Well, we all know he's not the greatest threat with the bat up there. His numbers certainly aren't that pretty, but hey, I give him credit. He's really working the count right here.
And that's taken for a strike on the inside corner. 2-1. Bases are empty here with two men out. Hit out towards second. Juan Devoto will take care of him at first, and the side is retired. So they breeze through this half of the inning. We play two full. It's the Reds one and the Marlins nothing. Here's Billy Hamilton standing in. He'll lead things off here in this one-run contest.
Yeah, that last at-bat, Daddy, he turned that fastball around. He didn't hit it a ton. He didn't hit it a country mile, but, hey, listen, a home run is a home run.
Now a fastball to start the third. That misses. It's ball one. The 1-0 is in there for strike one. The 1-1. High in the air out to center field. Anderson patrolling center makes the play. One out.
Now batter, shortstop, Cesar Hernandez.
Stepping into the box, Cesar Hernandez. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. First pitch on its way. And that pitch catches the inside corner. Looking at his career totals, Hernandez is slugging a little under the 400 mark, so the chances of his connecting with the ball right here aren't particularly good. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. And a breaking ball runs in and gets him, and I doubt there was any intent behind that.
And I'll tell you, this is the last guy in the lineup you want to put on base for free. He's probably feeling a little salty after getting drilled, and he's got speed to burn, so look for him to try and make something happen out there.
In is Joey Votto now, as he takes a fastball off the plate for a ball, 1-0. Now the 1-0 is a fastball that misses.
This is why I love having athleticism and speed on your team. You can tell the runner on first base is certainly messing with the mechanics of the pitcher.
Hernandez leads off first with one away. Now a throw over to first, but the runner's back easily. And again a throw, and the runner back safely. Outside, 3-0 now.
Wow, this is the kind of count you'd like to get your superstar hitters in, right? 3-0, you can bet he has the green light on this pitch.
This is hit the other way out toward left field. Dietrich has a play, two gone. And that brings up Scott Schebler. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. He's set. Here it comes. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball. The 1-0. His fastball taken high for a ball. Now the 2-0. A swing and a miss. That's the first strike.
Yeah, Matty, not only is this guy using all four quadrants, he's elevating, getting their eye level up with a quality fastball.
Now the 2-1. He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
I can't tell you how big a pitch the last one was. The difference between 3-1 and 2-2, 2-2, you're probably taking a turn for the dugout.
Looking at strike two, a fastball that catches the inside corner.
All right, 3-2 count with two outs. The runner on first will be moving, so we'll see what happens. There are a lot of possible outcomes with this kind of play.
Now the 3-2 pitch. Hit down the third baseline. But this will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2. The next 3-2. Full count still. Payoff pitch one more time. On a line, that's a base hit. And they won't even attempt to run on that arm in right. So despite the runner moving on the pitch, it'll wind up first and second here.
Dan, how frustrating that must be. 8 pitch at bat, and he's able to work a base hit.
D-Hero, he threw everything but the kitchen sink at him. He threw off-speed pitches, fastballs, and on the 8th pitch, left one out over the plate, just enough for a base hit.
Here's the second baseman, Scooter Gennett, as he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one. 0-for-1 here in the early going. He waits. Now the pitch. And here's a pitch high and tight for a ball. 1-1. And he chased one there as this is bounced to short. And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. Reds strand a couple, but they hold a 1-0 lead. Stepping up to the plate, number 30 will take his first hacks here.
First baseman. Number 30.
Here's the first pitch to him. Swung on and missed. Outclassed by that fastball for a strike.
Yeah, you attack the zone and get a swing and a miss that late on your first pitch fastball. Good chance he's coming right back with the same thing.
And it's quickly 0-2. Stung into the gap in right center for what should be extra bases. Legs churning. He's headed for second. And the Marlins have something cooking. It's a leadoff double.
Now that's the way you answer. They're down 1-0 already, but he laces the double and puts himself in the scoring position. That'll get the dugout fired up and excited to punch back.
Coming to the plate now, the pitcher for the Marlins, Andy Barnhart, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. First pitch of the at bat. Now a bunt attempt here. Pennington scoops it up. Throw on to first by Pennington, and there's one gone.
The batter number two.
Gene Segura standing in. Flied out at his first at bat, so making 0-for-1 so far. He comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Shot down the first baseline, and he'll take this one to the bag for the out. But meanwhile, the runner will move up 90 feet to third base.
Third baseman number 8, Jed Lowry.
Jed Lowry now, as he's got a chance to tie this ball game up with that equalizing run just 90 feet away at third. First pitch on its way. A changeup over the inside corner. Men on third with two down. Got him looking, and that ends the inning. Marlins leave one. They still trail 1-0. Ready for another chance? Tucker Barnhart. He drew a base on balls his first time up. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. Ready with the nothing and one pitch. Another one fouled off, and he's quickly behind 0-2. Count remains at 0-2. Tough pitch to lay off. The slider stays high for ball one.
Boy, that's a great breaking ball right there. That's a tough pitch to lay off when that ball is coming in at that plane right there. Quality take.
Two balls and two strikes to the Reds catcher. And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2.
Wow, from 0-2 to 3-2, and that last pitch on 2-2 wasn't even close. He had this guy in the ropes, but now he let him right back into this at bat.
3-2 pitch. Is in there, a called strike three.
Now batting, third baseman, left.
Trying to pick things up where we left off. Cliff Pennington. He'll try to follow up the double in his last at bat with another big hit right here. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Hit fairly well out towards straightaway center. Anderson giving chase, and a great diving effort there, but it'll just tip off his glove, and it's a base hit. And he is in there.
Well, he was definitely struggling coming into this one, but I think we could say that cold streak is officially over. That's his second hit of the game, and it goes for extra bases. We'll see now if this game proves to be a huge turning point for him.
That'll bring in Philip Irvin, as he'll take a look at a slider here that misses for ball one. Reached base via the walk in his first plate appearance. And a fastball in there for a strike, 1-1.
Hey, I don't mind that batter taking that strike right there. He's walked a couple people early in this game. Got to find out if he can find the zone. If he wants to walk them all in, we'll take it.
Pennington leads off second with one gone in the inning. And it's 1-2. The 1-2 misses for the second ball. And the slider gets him swinging, two gone.
Really good late bite on that slider right there. The best ones have that late action that just darts at the last minute. They're so tough to get the bat on, and when you've got that good slider going, it's a great strikeout pitch.
Standing in now, Robert Stevenson. As he'll swing and pop it up toward the left side of the infield. And the catch made here by Lowry, and that ends the inning. One left for Cincinnati, but they're on top 1-0. Leading off the inning, JT Realmuto. They'll look to get something going here and even this game up. First pitch of the at bat on its way, and that misses ball one. The 1-0 delivery, and they won't get him to chase the curveball in the dirt that time, and it's 2-0 now.
They obviously circled him before the game that they were not going to let him beat them. Walked him this first time up, and now they're nibbling again.
Now the 2-0. Too tight with that one. 3-0.
Great AB so far. I'd really like to see this guy work a walk and get on base for this team. Maybe give them a shot of confidence that they got a shot to get back in this one.
The 3-0. And that misses for ball four. It's a leadoff walk that starts the bottom of the fourth.
Well, they haven't been able to scratch a run across yet, so maybe this walk will jumpstart their offense a little bit.
Outfielder Stephen Piscotty, the next to hit, comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. First
he's
offering
going,
on its way. In there, now the throw. Ball's there, and he is out. Good throw.
Well, he showed a lot of patience to work out that walk, but it got erased pretty quickly. Always hate to give outs away on the base pass, especially when you've gotten on base for free.
Come on, Marlin.
Here we go. Here's one that misses high. It's 1-1. Swung on and missed, 1-2 now. No runs, just one hit, and no errors in the game for the Marlins. Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone.
Oh, man.
That strikeout was all about setting the hitter up with hard stuff. You can see the first three pitches are coming in fast, and then he slows it down on the fourth pitch, knowing the hitter is sort of conditioned for the hard stuff, yet another way to upset a hitter's timing.
Into the box, Derek Dietrich. As he takes a cold strike at the knees, it's 0-1. So far, 0-for-1 with a flyout. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. And a neck-high fastball that time. The 1-1 home is laid off for ball two. Three and one to the Marlins left fielder.
Time for him to attack on the mound. He knows his team's struggling offensively. Don't mess around and try and nibble. Just be on the attack and let them beat you.
Into his motion, here comes the 3-1. And a fastball misses there, ball four.
Looked like he might have gotten squeezed a little bit right there, and you know he's talking to himself in his head about it. That kind of stuff goes both ways, though. Hitters get their fair share of crummy calls going against them, too.
Stepping in now, Brian Anderson, as the first pitch to him is off the plate for a ball, 1-0. He's 0-for-1 thus far.
Come on, Brian.
And he'll lay off here as well, and it's 2-0 to the Miami third sacker. Swing and a miss. Might have got a piece, actually. It's 2-1. Dietrich, the runner at first with two gone. Strike two called, and it's even at two. Here now the 2-2. Pitch swung on and hit in the air toward the line and right. And he'll get there in plenty of time to put this one away, and that ends the inning. One left for Miami. It remains 1-0. Back to the top of the Reds lineup now, and stepping in, Billy Hamilton. He's 1-for-2 in this one.
Billy Hamilton.
First delivery to him on the way. A fastball off the plate away. It's ball one. The 1-0 home is laid off of down and in.
Let's go, Marlins.
That'll find its way out of play. Still going to have a good hitter's count. 2-1 now.
Hey.
Right over the middle, knee high. Two balls, two strikes, a crucial count for both pitcher and hitter. So, Dan, what was your approach on the mound in that count? Do you still pitch for the strikeout here?
I think one of the keys, Matt, you want to try to initiate contact. But one thing you don't want to do, you don't want to run the count to three balls and two strikes. Whatever you want to throw, throw it over for a strike.
Now batting, Cesar Hernandez.
Digging in once again, Cesar Hernandez. Last time up, he was hit by a pitch.
Get out of here, Reds.
First pitch coming. Here it is. There's a strike.
This is a tough spot here to turn two off this guy at the plate. One of the things you really have to make sure defensively to make sure you get at least one out. Don't try to turn that double play. If you get the sure out at second, take that. If you get it at first, well, that's just an added bonus. But make sure you at least get one out in a spot
he's
like
going,
this.
Look out. There goes Hamilton. Here's a weakly hit fly ball off to the left side. Dives, and he hangs on for the out. Wow.
That one had extra bases written all over it. Great sliding catch, and he also kept the runners right where they were at.
Joey Votto pitches high. The throw. He's in there easily as the throw bounces on the way down.
Good steal there, and I'll tell you, he is a multi-dimensional player out there. He's got good pop at the plate, and he showed he's not afraid to use his wheels on the bases either.
To your point, Dan, he did go deep earlier, and now the stolen base here, so he's really having an impact on this game. He's ready. Here's the 1-0. Just a bit high that time as he misses for a ball.
He's obviously been very impressive on the mound in this one, and I think the big reason why is his ability to stay out of the middle of the zone. That's kind of obvious, but it's clear to me that even when he misses his spots, he's not missing over the plate.
A fastball that finds the outside corner.
Hey, you get 2-0, your eyes light up, but you're sitting in one spot. And he obviously didn't get it right there. But he still finds himself in a 2-1 count, ready to do some damage.
2-1, here it is. And this pitch is hit foul off to the left and out of play. So the count goes to 2-2 now. All even at 2-2, here it is. And there's one well above the zone for a ball.
Looked like he tried to elevate a fastball on that 2-2 pitch there, but kind of overdid it. With a pitch that high, it's pretty easy to lay off if you're the hitter.
Now the 3-2 pitch. And this one's chopped foul right at home plate. One run, five hits, and no errors in the game for Cincinnati thus far. Ground ball sent back up the middle. Segura fields it cleanly on the first, and Votto's gone for out number two.
Now batting, right fielder. Your attention, please. Now pitching for the Marlins, number 38, Mike Montgomery.
Scott Scheffler will be his first assignment upon entering as he'll bat with the runner in scoring position here and two away. Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch. Takes a look down at the knees for a strike. Two outs here with a runner at third. Behind 0-2 now.
Hey, great swing right there. I know the ball foul, but he absolutely laced that pitch right there. He's just got to stay back a little bit longer.
Up around the face.
Boy, if you're going to throw a pitch like that to this guy, you have to make sure it's up above the zone like that. He can't do a whole lot with that, but if it were a little lower, he can and will make you pay big time.
The 1-2. Is a curveball in the dirt.
Pretty standard curve in the dirt, looking for a strike out there, but that was a good job of recognizing it and holding back at the plate.
Here now the 2-2. Is looked at and the count moves full.
Wow, this is a pretty good at bat right here, from down in the count 0-2 to work the count back to 3-2, and he's seen a lot of pitches too.
The men on third with two down.
Come on, Marlin.
Count remains full. Once again, a 3-2. And the cutter got him swinging. Strike three, and the side is retired. Reds lead one, but they're up 1-0. leading off the inning, Leo Estrada. And they'll need him to get something going here.
Leo Estrada.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Takes a look at a strike over the inside corner. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-1. And he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two. The windup and the 0-2 pitch. Now the fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning. Little bit over halfway home tonight, bottom of the fifth, as we get a look at our line score to this point. And boy, just one hit for these guys, and they have not swung the bats well. That's putting it mildly. Riding in once again, number 30. It was a double for him in his first turn at the plate. First pitch of the at bat.
Nope.
Up and in for ball one. Now the 1-0 is looked at for the first strike. Bases are empty, one man out.
Zero.
A ball and two strikes now.
You know, we haven't seen that pitch from him in a while, but it looks like he's got pretty good feel for it. If he's going to pick and choose when he's going to use it, he could steal some strikes that way.
And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. Here now the 2-2. Doesn't get the zone. Count full now. Oh, and he lets him off the hook there, as this isn't even close for ball four.
He's going to be pretty upset with himself about that 3-2 pitch. All you want to do in that count is make a competitive pitch, but that one wasn't even sniffing the zone, and he let him get away.
Alex Hockett will be summoned off the bench here as he'll pinch hit with a runner at first and one gone in the inning. Ground ball to second. This could be two. There's one. On to Votto, a double play, and that ends the inning. 4-6-3. They roll it up to get out of the jam. We're back to Friday Night Baseball on the show after this.
Your attention, please. Now pitching for the Marlins, number 62.
Here's the second baseman, Scooter Gennett. He started out the evening 0-for-2 so far. Here's the first pitch to him. Comes right after him with a fastball for a strike. Looks like a left-hander up and throwing now in that Marlins bullpen. On its way, the 0-1 pitch. Swinging strike, and now it's 0-2. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. And he goes up the ladder on him, but he lays off 1-2.
That one missed, but if it's a strike, I don't know how you get the barrel of that pitch. You have to really be sitting on it to hit a fastball coming in that hard on the inside part of the plate.
The 1-2. Misses above the zone for a ball. Now a changeup locks him up as he looks at strike three called, one away.
Well, we've seen some really good pitching from these guys in this one. The bullpen has looked sharp and have backed up a nice effort turned in by the starter. These days, pitching has become a full staff effort, and I've been impressed with the job these guys have done so far.
First pitch coming, here it is. And this runs inside, and that looked like it got him pretty good.
Now batting.
Digging in and looking for more, Cliff Pennington. It was a two-bagger for him in his last at-bat. Here comes the first pitch. And that one stayed up a little high. Barnhart, base runner at first with one out. One and one to count. Now the 1-1 pitch. Count is 1-2 now. Lifted in the air to center field. Anderson is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. That'll bring in Philip Irvin.
Left fielder, Philip Irvin.
From the stretch, here's the pitch. And a fastball just a bit high. Looks at a changeup on the inside corner for a strike. The 1-1. Swing and a little tapper. That winds up foul for the second strike. And a fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight. One left for Cincinnati, but they lead it 1-0. Gene Segura standing in to start things out in their half of the sixth as they look to shake things up here for a lineup that, quite frankly, has been non-existent to date.
No doubt about that, Matt. They've been completely overmatched to this point. One hit through five innings. I mean, what else can you say about the pitching they face other than it's been fantastic? We'll see if that continues as we approach the later inning.
First pitch on its way. Takes a knee-high fastball.
You can tell this offense is getting frustrated, but this might be one you have to shower off. When a guy's locating like this, fastball at the knees and to both corners, it's going to be tough for them to do anything with it.
And the pitch. And now a curveball that bounces up to the plate. It's 1-1. The 1-1. Swinging a ball hit softly on the ground, but a foul ball, 1-2 now. And that misses 2-2. Here now the 2-2. Count remains 2-2. Ready with another 2-2. Rounded down the third baseline. Up with it now is Pennington, and that's the first out.
Third baseman, number 8, Jed Lowry.
Here's Jed Lowry now. No hits to this point. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. A high fastball is in there. Oh, one count. Here's the pitch. Thought he had the inside corner that time, but it missed for ball one. Here's the pitch. And a breaking ball runs in and gets him, and I doubt there was any intent behind that.
Well, when you hear people talk about the unwritten rules of baseball, I think we just saw a perfect example of that. You hit one of mine, and I'm going to hit one of yours. Always been that way and probably always will be, even though they've tried to crack down on that kind of stuff recently.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, JT Realmuto. A couple of walks for him thus far. Ready. Here's the first offering. Offered at and missed. Here's the throw. And it's going to be in plenty of time as Lowry is out at second.
Clearly, they were hoping to be aggressive and doing some running tonight, but I think they're going to need to adapt now. It's not working, and you just can't keep running into outs.
The windup and the 0-1. Hard on the ground towards short. Great effort on the dive, but it's through into left. So a two-out single gives him new life here in the inning, but it's a bright spot in what's been a fairly dismal season offensively for them in terms of overall batting average. And you can see the bad news right there. They rank dead last among the 15 National League teams in that category. Ready for another shot now, Stephen Piscotty. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up. On its way is pitch number 75. And that one just missed outside.
Well, that was a big two-out single we just saw, and for pretty obvious reasons. The inning went from totally under control to now. He's got to deal with some dangerous hitters here with a runner on base, and this is how two-out rallies start.
The 1-0 finds the zone, strike one.
One ball, one strike.
Down low, two balls and a strike. Never tempted to swing at that ball down low. It's ball three.
No reason to sit on anything other than hard stuff in a location you like and drive it right now.
Realmuto leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. Good at bat that time as he lays off for ball four. And as a result, that'll move a runner up into scoring position now with two away.
Well, they've struggled offensively in this one so far, but after that walk, they've got runners at first and second and look ready to make a little noise. Just need a big hit now.
Up next from Miami, Derek Dietrich. We'll see if he can come through in a clutch spot here. Two on, two out here in inning number six. Trying to hold the lead. Here's the delivery. Early swing there as he pulls it foul to the right side.
He might not want to throw that one again. I know his timing was a little bit off at the dish, but he kept his hands back. Just missed that one. Fouled that one off really hard.
Two men are on with two men out. And a fastball called strike three, and the side is retired. Marlins strand a pair. They're down 1-0. Welcome back to South Florida. Reds leading this one as we start the seventh. And before we commence, let's take a look at the game summary to this point. So here's the Reds pitcher, Robert Stephenson. He'll be tasked with starting things as we begin the seventh.
Robert Stephenson.
Here's the first pitch to him. Takes a look at one catching the outside corner. The 0-1. Good changeup that time, but he wouldn't bite on it. Ready with the 1-1 pitch. Swung on and missed. Outclassed by that fastball for a strike. The 1-2 is looked at off the plate for a ball.
I like that they went away with that pitch right there.
They really tried to tie him up on that previous pitch, so he was probably what we call inside conscious. He didn't get a strike there, but I'm guessing he was looking for another ball in.
Fastball called, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning.
Nice job there taking care of the leadoff hitter via the strikeout. I'll tell you, in a one-run game, especially this late, getting that first guy in the inning is so important. It changes the whole complexion of the inning, so that was a big out.
Billy Hamilton stand in again as we take you back to earlier in the ballgame. This one swing here has been the entire offense to this point, as this home run accounted for the only run they've tallied so far. Here comes the first pitch. And the changeup is way low that time. Head to head with Jose Urena. Just a couple of matchups, no hits in two at bats. That one's going to find the seats, strike one. One and two, the count to Billy Hamilton. One out, nobody on. And he'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at two and two. And he misses this one inside, and that'll run things full, three and two.
Time to focus here. This game is way too close to be walking, guys, so we'll see if he can make him swing the bat on this next pitch.
3-2 pitch. Line drive, and that's a base hit into center field.
Nice piece of hitting right there. Kept his shoulders square, his hands inside the baseball, and was able to fight off a good, nice executed pitch for a knock.
Standing in now, Cesar Hernandez, as he'll swing and pop this one up near second base. Estrada is there, two down. So it's a runner at first with two men out, and standing in is the on-base machine, first baseman Joey Votto. Here's a look over to first and a dive, but he's back in there.
He's ready.
Here's the first offering. A pitch out. The throw. And even a pitch out can't do the trick. He's in there at second. So he swipes second despite the pitch out.
Yeah, it seemed like everyone in the building knew he was going to be running there, right? Didn't make a difference, though. He got a great jump and absolutely burned it down to second to get in safely.
Hamilton at second with two down. This is hit the other way out toward left field. Dietrich moves over. He makes the play, and that'll end the inning. Reds leave one, but they hold a 1-0 lead. Ready once again, Brian Anderson. He's 0-for-2 thus far in this one.
Starting to run out of time. They haven't been able to score any runs as we're moving late into this one. A perfect time for this leadoff guy to try to get on base and ignite a rally.
First delivery to him on the way. Hit the other way out toward right field. Shebler has it in his tracks. He's got it one away.
Now batting. Second baseman. Leo.
Digging in to try it again. Leo Estrada. First pitch on its way. And he turns on one, sending it high and deep to right. That one is out of here. This game is tied. A solo shot here to straightaway right field. Home run number 5 on the year. And with it, the Marlins are back even now at 1-1.
we're all tied up, and it's anybody's ball game after that blast. We live in that "what have you done for me lately" world, so that gem he was pitching doesn't mean anything anymore.
Here comes Brian Price now out of the Reds' dugout on his way to the mound. And a change is forthcoming, as that's going to do it for his starter here this evening. So he departs in a tie ball game here tonight. You can already hang a no decision on him for this one. Justin Nicolino takes the call from the pen as he'll try to get the final two outs of this seventh frame. Into the box, number 30. As the first pitch to him is a changeup that can't find the zone, it's ball one. The 1-0 is outside for a ball.
It's never advantageous to fall behind 2-0 as a pitcher, but if you're going to do it, it's far better to do it with a guy down in the bottom of the order. Time for a challenge fastball right here, though.
2-0 count, the pitch is up and away, but called a strike. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. This is in the air out to straightaway center, and he will make the play out there, and there are two away now.
The pitcher number 62,
Tim Conway, will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
Number 28, Tim Conway.
Line drive to center field. That gets down, and the inning continues. So the two-out hit here brings up Gene Segura.
That's what we refer to in the biz as a hanger right there. He's lucky he's getting his baseball back.
Into the box now, Gene Segura. And they pitch out here, but nothing's going on. Two out with the possible go-ahead run at first. Before the delivery, a check on that go-ahead run at first. And a dive, but he's back in. The 1-0 home. Sent on the ground out to second. Jeanette has it on to first, and this will remain a tie ball game as the inning is over. Marlins able to knock things up on the solo home run. Seven complete here tonight, all even at one apiece. Ryan Tepera has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Ryan Tepera.
And that brings up Scott Schebler. Due up for the 4, 5, and 6 hitters, and they're hoping that this is the part of the lineup that can get something going.
Yeah, only one run on the board so far for them. They just haven't had consistently good at-bats.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Swing and a miss, 0-1. Now the pitch, and this one's downstairs. It's a ball and a strike. Well, they'll run this one in on him, and he can't connect, so he finds himself down 1-2 now.
Two things pitchers really love: called strike threes and jamming hitters. How about that? Talk about that jam right there. That's about as good as it gets.
The 1-2. Taken down and in for a ball.
Most good pitchers know that they have to work inside and sometimes even come off the plate to keep hitters from getting comfortable up there. I think that was part of the intent with that last pitch.
Now a cutter, but that's in the dirt for a ball. The 3-2 pitch is a swing and a miss. That's strike three.
I really liked it. He gave up nibbling out of the zone trying to get him to chase. That wasn't working, so he just reached back and fired a good old country hardball fastball right by him. No better feeling in the world when you're a pitcher than throwing a fastball right by a guy.
In now, Scooter Gennett, as he'll go after the first pitch and bounce it into foul territory. He could really use a knock here, 0 for 3 in the game so far. And there's ball one. Marlins have some action in the bullpen now as a right-hander is up and throwing. The 1-1 home. Sent on the ground out to second. Estrada comes up with it. And there's out number two.
Up next for Cincinnati, catcher Tucker Barnhart.
Digging in the switch hitter, Tucker Barnhart. He's got to be looking for vengeance after getting plunked in his last at bat. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Sliders in for a strike. The 0-1 on its way. A swing and a shot hit down the corner, but it bends just foul into the second deck. Here comes the nothing and two pitch. Again, he sends it out of play. Two quick strikes, and now the 0-2. And he looks at a ball, 1-2. The 1-2. This is on the ground over to first. The flip to the pitcher covering, and that will retire the side. Reds are down in order, still tied one apiece. Digging in, Jed Lowry. 0-2 with a hit by pitch so far.
Jed Lowry.
Here's the first pitch to him. A high fastball is in there. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Now a swing and a hard hit grounder. This will get foul for strike two.
Here we go.
Now a fastball here that'll wisely lay off, and it's 1-2.
Hey, I can understand why he wanted to elevate the fastball right there. This batter's eyes have been lit up since he stepped in the box. Let's see if he gets him fishing on something breaking in the dirt right here.
Ready to deliver the 1-2. Chopped weakly to the left. Hernandez ranges to his right. And there's one down now.
The batter, catcher, J.T. Realmuto.
Ready now for the Marlins, J.T. Realmuto. Last time through was a base hit. First pitch coming. Here it is. There's a fastball right over the inside corner. Bases are empty, one man out. A swinging bunt out in front of the plate. And very quickly there, they're two gone to start the inning.
Now batter, right fielder, Steven.
Outfielder Stephen Piscotty the next to hit. 0 for 2 with a walk for him so far. Here comes the first pitch. Donnie extends nicely, and this ball is driven to right field and deep. And, oh, trouble averted as he takes away extra bases, and the inning is over. One more look at the final out. A teeth rattler if ever there was one. We're back to Friday Night Baseball on the show after this. Ah, the famous neon lights of Ocean Drive in Miami Beach. Welcome back to Baseball on the Show. Drew Steckenrider will be on the mound to start the ninth inning, and his job will be keeping the ball game tied until the bottom half. Bill Gosselin is going to come on and pinch hit here, and this is an important at-bat, leading things off in the ninth in a tie ball game. Here we go with inning number nine as the first pitch misses for ball one. And he's carrying a batting average of just over 300. So clearly he's been a productive player with the bat in his hand so far. The 1-0 home. And this is going to find the crowd down the left field line. It's a ball and a strike.
Might have been cheating for another fastball trying to get the head to that one early. Pitcher pulled the string with a nasty breaking ball and had him a little bit out in front.
2-1 the count. He's fallen behind now, 3-1. We see a right-handed batter waiting next, but he could very well be pulled back as the situation dictates. No leadoff walk just yet as that finds the strike zone and the count comes full at 3-2. Now the payoff pitch home is a swing and a miss. That's strike three.
Now back. Left fielder.
Riding in once again, Philip Irvin. It's been an 0-for-2 effort for him to this point. From the stretch. And there's a pitch that just misses the inside corner. One out, nobody on. Softly hit to the left side. And a base hit as that's into left, and they've got themselves a base runner.
Boy, D-Roll, that ball wasn't hit very hard, but when you're struggling like this guy is, any knock is a good knock.
Yeah, 100%. He doesn't usually get those. He has to square it up mid-barrel to find a way to get a knock. He hasn't had much luck this year, but he'll take that any day.
Jesse Winker will be called upon here to hit with the game on the line. For the delivery, a check on that go-ahead run at first. And that's inside for a ball, 1-0. Possible go-ahead runs on first, one away. Here's a fastball that's nowhere near the zone. It's 2-0 now.
Well, you can see what he's trying to do right there. Double play situation. Two balls down in the zone trying to get that ground ball. Didn't get him to bite at either one. Now he's behind in the count, 2-0.
This is hit the other way out toward left field. Dietrich is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. Back to the top of the Reds lineup now, and stepping in, Billy Hamilton. There are two gone and the possible go-ahead run at first. Here's the first pitch. Thought he had the inside corner that time, but it missed for ball one. The 1-0. Runner goes for second. Pitch outside. The throw. And it's far too late as he steals second with ease.
It was pretty obvious he would likely be on the move with two outs, and I'm sure the defense knew it too. But he has lightning speed and was able to take the bag anyways.
Now the 2-0 on the ground to third. Taken there by Lowry. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. So no runs here on a base hit, no errors, and one man left aboard. The Marlins with a chance to walk it off as we go to the bottom of the ninth. Phil Gosselin is going to go ahead and stay in the ballgame and play third now.
Now playing third base, number 46.
Homer Bailey enters to do the pitching, and best case scenario for him is to push this one into extra innings.
Homer Bailey.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Derek Dietrich. Lifetime numbers against Bailey. He's only 2-for-10.
Derek Dietrich.
First pitch on its way. And that one just missed outside. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. The 1-0. A swing and a miss, strike one. Bailey, a 6'4" right-hander. This is his 12th season in the big league, so he's put together a really nice career to this point.
Yeah, Matty, you ain't kidding right there. 10 years, we refer to that in the biz as hitting full potential.
And look out as this one catches him, and a big mistake there as now the go-ahead run is aboard to lead off the inning.
And this is the case of a guy taking one for the team. I think he could have gotten out of the way of this one, but he leans into it and puts himself on board. Now he represents the winning run, so it's a good move.
Now time is called, and a very wise decision here with the potential winning run at first. They'll opt to put a little extra speed on the base pass. Standing in now, Brian Anderson. As he'll square around to bunt, then pull back for ball one. The winning run is at first base. Now a bunt attempt here. And good hustle to get over and tag him for the out.
Sacrifice was in order right there as he gets the bunt down right there. And sometimes it's easier to just tag him instead of making that throw to first base.
Trying to pick things up where we left off, Leo Estrada. And he's got a chance to bring in the winning run. The question is whether they'll even pitch to him.
The last at bat, Matty B, we heard this guy's a good fastball hitter. He got a fastball, didn't miss it. We'll see if they pitch him a little bit differently this time and mix in some off-speed pitches.
Here's the first pitch. Right over the middle, knee high. Possible game winners at second base here with one away. That's over, but low. It's a ball and a strike. Oh, and this is lined into center field. It's down for a base hit. Oh, and the throw's wide as it gets by him at second. And the winning run is across to score.
Well, that at bat shows clearer than anything that some guys, they have that clutch gene and some guys just don't. He brings home the winning run from second and is being absolutely mobbed by his teammates. What a finish.
Not a lot of runs put on the board in this one, but here's a guy that found a way to make a difference. He's the top player of the game.
Yeah, he delivered when it mattered most with the walk-off base hit, so better get his recognition. I just hope this guy didn't pummel him too hard when they went out there celebrating on the field.
close one tonight. 2-1 the final score. The Miami Marlins came through when it mattered in the ninth on the way to the win. Drew Steckenrider earns his third win of the year in relief. So that'll just about do it. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. This has been a presentation of MLB.